Hello and good evening, everyone. Today we're going to talk about how to become an airline pilot in India. My name is Vandika Lamba. I'm a co-founder of Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. You can find us on www.aircruiseaviation.com. My details are there in front of your screen. You can find us on our social media, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Instagram for more information. See, when you become a pilot, you not only get to soar up in the skies, but also in your career and life. Commercial pilots are paid one of the highest salaries in India. Domestic airlines in India pay as much as 1.5 lakhs for a fresh pilot. With the years of experience as a pilot, the salary goes up on the international routes. Experienced pilots operating on international routes are paid as much as 5 to 6 lakhs rupees per month. Let's talk about some eligibility criteria. If you aspire to become a pilot in your life, you must first choose your higher secondary course with subjects including physics, chemistry, and mathematics. You must have scored a minimum of 50% in these subjects to be able to join an air flying school. Once you complete your 10 plus 2 examination, you must join an air flying school in the country. It is always good to choose the best air flying school so that you land on the attractive career opportunities even as you get out of your course. The courses and the training that you will have to complete in these flying schools include SPL, PPL, and CPL, which means student pilot license, private pilot license, and commercial private license. These are some of the top flying schools in India. You can follow this. This is as per the survey. To name few, it is one is in Calcutta, Guwahati, Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow, Hyderabad, Jaipur, and Bangalore. Let's talk about when you are entering a flying school in India. To enter a flying school in India, you must take the entrance test offered by them exclusively. In addition, you also need to clear physical fitness criteria specified by these schools. In fact, this is the toughest part of the job. Only perfectly fit persons can get admissions in flying schools. Becoming a pilot. After completing the training, the candidates get the license to pursue a career in piloting. Airline companies hire the most successful candidates trained by these schools as trainees. During their training stage, the salary will not be high. Even the training period, the regular pilots get paid high salary. Even after you become a commercial pilot, you will need to undergo a thorough medical checkup. Health problems can lead to the cancellation of the pilot's license. Hence, the job of a pilot can be highly challenging as well as rewarding. Now, let's talk about when you join the Indian Air Force. You should not confuse yourself between a regular pilot and a pilot with the Indian Air Force. Indian Air Force pilots are recruited through the NDA examinations. These trainings are offered free of cost. Once inducted into the Indian Air Force, these pilots get salaries on par with the Indian government salary. Let's talk about the qualifications to become a pilot. For Indian Air Force, your minimum qualification should be senior secondary or higher secondary. Your minimum age should be 18 years, good communication skills, and you should have a physical and mental fitness. You should be medically fit. And there's an exam which is conducted by Indian Air Force. You need to complete that. For private pilot, the minimum qualifications, the age, it remains the same as it goes with Indian Air Force. You should have good communication skills. You should have level 2 medical and mental fitness certificate. And as I talk about your entrance exam at the flying schools. Now, there are some important points which I have summed up for becoming a pilot. Those wishing to learn flying, they have two options. Either you can enroll or qualify study with the armed forces of the country, or you can attend the state-run or private flying schools that flourish around the world. You should have excellent physical and mental fitness, your academic qualifications, which are required to enter the flying schools. The basic private pilot course is of 30 to 60 days, which costs about $10,000 in the US, but it excludes the rent for the trainer aircraft. Hiring a trainer aircraft depends upon number of hours a student needs to learn with the flying instructor. And as I told you earlier, the flying is taught free to the military pilots. They are required to compulsory serve their nation's armed forces for a fixed number of years in lieu of this training. Let's talk about what the training includes here. We have instruments rating training. It talks about your cockpit instruments. Instruments check training. It talks about whatever instruments you have on board, which are essential to flight. Meteorological and weather training. Budding pilots are trained on how to manage flying in various, bad weather conditions. Non-fixed wing aircraft training. This training is taken by helicopter pilots. Let's talk about flying as a profession. See, the obsession of flying, it grows stronger day by day among the humans. Post 1903, after Orwell and Wilbur Wright made their first merchandise flight at Kell Devil's Hills, the primitive flight of a few hundred meters to rapid development of aviation. Thanks to advances in various fields, it is now possible to take lessons at flying schools to becoming a pilot. So, these are some of the quotes we have. I belong in the air. Let's talk about some unique skills. We have already talked about good communication skills, physically fit, ability to remain calm, mentally, confidence, attitude, self-discipline, leadership, etc. Well, we have some books. You can also follow this for your career guide as a pilot's career guide, which is easily available on Amazon. And for more information, I am sharing my personal details with you. You can follow us on for any advice and suggestions. Thank you. Thank you so much.